start.
Hello my children, welcome back to the SST classroom. Now in the last video we discussed about the new chapter, that is lesson number 3, Indian desert. Am I right? Now what we have discussed in that, we discussed about the desert. Can you tell me what is desert? A desert is a large area which is covered with sand, is known as desert. Later we discuss about the landscape of the desert. So what we talk about the landscape of the desert? We talk that the desert having the extreme temperature, and here there is very less vegetation are grown in this region because here the climate is very hot. Now we talk mostly the desert, it falls in the tropical belt of the world. Am I right? And then after that, we discuss about the climate. So what we discuss about the climate? How is the climate in the desert area? The climate remains hot and dry throughout the year. If you talk about the summer are, the day are very hot and the night are cold. And if you talk about the winter, the day are warm and the night are very cold. Now why in the desert area the night are very cold? Because the sand, it cool down very quickly. Because of that, the night in summer and in winter also, it remains very cold. Now today we are going to discuss about the Thar Desert, which is located in the northwestern part of India. And this desert is also known as the Great Indian Desert or Thar Desert. Now we will see the location of the Thar Desert. Come on, now look at this map. It is located to the west of the Aravali Hills. Can you see here the Aravali Hills, which is lying in the northwestern part? Now my dear children, we will talk about the Thar Desert. Thar Desert, it is partly rocky and partly it is sandy. You can see in the picture in the about the Thar Desert, partly you will see the rocky place and partly you will see the sandy. Now, if we talk about the Thar Desert, it is located, where it located in India? Anyone, and you have any idea? You have learned in the third standard. So, Thar Desert, it is located to the northwestern part of India. Now, to the northwestern part of India, you will see the Thar Desert, which is located here. This desert is also known as the Great Indian Desert. Let's talk about the location of the Thar Desert. It is located to the west of Aravali Hills. Now you see in the map, Aravali Hills, can you see the Aravali Hills over here? So Aravali Hills, if you will see Aravali Hills, up you will see the north, down you will see the south, and next you will see the east. So where it is located, the Thar Desert? To the west of Aravali Hills in Rajasthan. Now it is located to the northwestern part of India. After that you will see that at what it is extended. Now, it extends from run of Kutch in Gujarat to the Punjab and Haryana in the north. So, up till where it extended, this Thar Desert? It extends from run of Kutch in Gujarat till Punjab and Haryana to the north. After that, we will discuss about the Thar Desert. In India, it occupies an area of 208,110 km. So, in India, how much area it occupies? 208,110 km. However, the major part of the area falls in Rajasthan. As I explained you, it extends from run of Kutch in Gujarat till Punjab and Haryana in the north, but the major part of this desert falls in Rajasthan. So where this major part of the desert falls? In which place? Rajasthan. As you know, the Rajasthan is the largest state of our India. Got it? So the major part of the Rajasthan falls in the desert. The major part of the desert falls in Rajasthan. Now, after that we will talk about the sand dunes. Now you know what is sand dunes? There are small hills of sand that is known as sand dunes. Now why the sand dunes happen in the desert region? You know any idea? Here the hot and dry wind here blow in this area. Because of that, because of the strong wind, you will see the sand dune. Means you will see the land keeps on changing their size and shape. Why? Because of the wind, strong wind which blow in this part. So because of strong wind which blow in this region, here you will see the sand dunes are formed. So these sand dunes keeps on changing their shape and size. Hope till here you have understood about the desert, Thar desert. Later we'll discuss if you will see about the sand dunes. Now if you are in the sand dunes, you will see there is a strong wind which blow in this. We can say the sandstorm. What happened? Anyone can lost in this sand dunes. Anyone can easily get lost in the sand. Now here the Luni is only the major river which flow in this part. Hope till here you have understood about the Thar desert. Now later we will discuss about the oasis. Now what is this oasis? Now at some places in desert, underground water comes out through the surface, through the spring. That is known as oasis. And this land is very fertile. Mostly all the villages are settled down near the oasis. So what I explain you about the oasis? That at some places in desert, underground water comes out through the spring. That is known as oasis. And the here in the oasis, this land become very fertile. And here you will see the date palm trees are grown near the oasis. Hope till here you have understood about the Thar desert. Now my dear children, what you have to do? You have to read the textbook. You have to underline the new words. And I will give you the three questions. That question you have to find out the answer from your textbook. And you have to note down in your notebook. So my first question is, what is desert? Note down this question, what is desert? So my second question is, how is the climate in the desert? And my third question is, where the Great Indian Desert is located? Or you can say, where the Great Indian Desert is situated? So this is my three questions, which is your today's homework. We have to find out the answer from your textbook and you have to note down in your notebook. Thank you.